Greetings, Beautiful Gamers, it's Boardreams. Welcome to another Runeterra video. As I promised, I am doing what I believe to be the fastest champion to speedrun with. For those who guessed the champion before, you are somewhat smart. And another thing is, I know that I said I would do a commentary speedrun, however, it appears that it is not going to be efficient to do that. Due to the number of times I reset and due to other reasons that I'm not going into right now. Therefore, we're gonna have it the old way. So, for those runs, we are going to be going by the in-game timer. I just added the other timer to have a feeling of how fast I'm going and know when I'm going too slow and have a reset if needed. So let's start by discussing the build of Diana and her strategy. Back in the days, if you watch my old Aurelion Sol speedruns, you will notice that I used to use Gale Force, which was broken at the time before Riot decided to nerf it, sadly. And I believe if we still have that old Gale Force, we would have had a much faster runs than we currently have. I'm gonna try to break my own records at all times, but will be proven harder and harder with time. So the build as of now, until I find a more efficient build, is as follow: Troll King's Crown, which gives overwhelm to every ally including Diana, Corrupted Star Fragment, which allows me to increase Diana's stats and therefore get more out of her double attack, and lastly Guardian Angel, which isn't the most ideal relic, but I'll do for now. For the strategy, as of now, I have yet to do enough runs to find out the best starting power and support champion for Diana. And although my number of resets is now in the 20s, I have yet to see a legendary power. I guess Riots have made them even more rare to find. I will shortly gather more information about the adventure, find the best strategy, the fastest route, and the kind of luck needed to achieve a fast run. In this run, however, I have found a power that is so useful for our strategy with Diana that I always want to get it. I will talk about it more when we get to it. The way I choose the route now is by considering how fast I can do it and what kind of power I'm getting when I go through that route. I also have to consider if the route is risky and if the power is worth the risk. For example, I will always avoid Gold Path, if possible. Prioritize champion's power route, unless the route has an encounter with round start freezing my strongest unit, which ultimately will slow the run down quite significantly. So I choose the encounter that I'm going for. If my starting hand have Diana and a 1 mana card that allows me to activate Nightfall effects, I will avoid rerolling to save a few seconds, unless I have a card that I wish to get in my starting hand. For example, in this run, I prefer having both of my champions in my starting hand, because as you saw, I get a power on my support champion that allows me to summon both round 1. A way to maximize the chances of getting the champion that I'm looking for, which you will notice me doing in all of my runs, if I get the other champion in my hand, I will always keep it, because that will maximize my chances of drawing the other champion because of the level 20 power, which is game start draw a champion. It's going to be more likely the champion that I don't have in my hand because it is simple math. I have more copies of it in my deck. Another way to manipulate the odds is to shuffle more copies of the champion whenever you get the chance to do so. Another thing I must mention is that you need to avoid leveling up a champion if not needed for the strategy, because winning without leveling up the champion is way faster due to not having to sit through the level up animation. I would also advise you to avoid invoking, manifesting, and predicting if possible. Those extra seconds add up. Now, obviously, I have made mistakes here and there that cost me some time during the run. However, With time, I will get back to understanding and making fast and well-informed decisions on the fly, as I will become more experienced with the adventure, just like Aurelion Soul Adventure and the times that we have achieved with time. I will also be able to give you more specific advice about the routes that you immediately go for if you see it, and those that you immediately avoid due to their clear time being super fast or super slow, respectively. A very nice skill to have is to think during the dead time that you can't make a move in. I'm talking about when the AI is playing or during the animation time. Thinking about your next move during this time will save you a considerable amount of time. Spamming the pass button would also save you time. What's better is using a spacebar to do that, which I'm sure you noticed that I'm using the button instead, but I have a valid reason for it. I spilled a soft drink on my keyboard and now it is sticky. Yes, it is a drink, not my sexy juice. And no, I will not apologize for that inappropriate joke. You know what channel you clicked on. Unless you knew, then hi, don't let your kids watch me. Also, you shouldn't go for over damage if not needed. What I mean, attack with only the units that you need to attack with to win, and avoid spending extra seconds on the other unit's attack, unless you are trying to play it safe against a freeze or the sort of scars that would add up more time than it's worth to not attack with them. Circling back to the power that I mentioned earlier, you just saw me considering it, and what made me go for it is the same exact reason you will see during the run. Lysandra has an annoying amount of freezes and entombs, not forgetting buried in ice of course, which can slow me down significantly if not kill the run, which had happened to me on few of my runs that I have done and considered not worthy of a video. You will not see them. Therefore, eliminating that possibility is a safety strategy worth going for. In case you don't know the power, and you didn't get to read what it does, let me tell you about it. Whenever I level up a champion, both me and the AI discard our hand. And the way it works, if I have leveled up my champion with a card that draws me a card or cards, the effect of the power will go first, allowing me to draw and have cards while my opponent will not. I believe I have already shown you the things that you must do and the things that you mustn't do. The things that will help you save time and the things that will ultimately just add on your time. The things that you must avoid to actually save your time, which is something you must do for a speedrun. After this encounter, you will see that I have no chance but to go for the one route, because the other route will have two encounters instead of one, which just will add on my time and ultimately not worth it. The mistake that I have done here is actually summoning an extra unit with a skill as well, which add on my time, because it was not necessary because I already have enough damage on the board to actually win this encounter without summoning this unit. So summoning this unit was just a waste of time. So remember, don't do that, that's stupid, and that will cost you time. Sadly, I did it. Another thing, I hate the fact that I'm spending too much time thinking about my options. I should be faster, but remember, I'm rusty. It's been so long since I last did a speedrun. It's been so long away from Runeterra, so now I'm coming back and I'm gonna get back my speed, my loveliness, and everything. And you already saw by me beating Aurelion Soul with 1 stars, and now starting to speedrunning. Did I just say Aurelion Soul? I meant Lysandra. You knew what I meant. Although this one is scripted, I still made a mistake. And I'm gonna include it, because why not? Scripted videos. On the topic, I hope you like them, because this is the kind of videos I can make nowadays due to my work and because everyone is sleeping at the moment, and my current room does not have the soundproof system as my old recording room did, and it will not for a long time because money does not grow on trees and other reasons. So yeah, I hope you like it. For now, I will leave you to the run until I have something to share with you. So enjoy it. Another thing to mention here is the fact that I went for Trundur instead of Anivia. That's an important thing because in Anivia state, Anivia will start with thin mana, which is more cards that the AI can play than Trundur. Another thing is that Anivia spell is a free spell, which will obviously slow us down. So at all cost, you must avoid Anivia during your speedrun, because I cannot see a way for Anivia not to be able to play anything around 1. Worst case scenario, she'll play herself and she will have another copy of her which will turn into Harsh Winds. Not good for you. Sadly here, I made a horrible mistake that cost me so much time, because I lost the match which I had to redo, and it is a mid boss match. That means they have more things to play and more HP, and redoing this is a hard thing. Sadly, I didn't notice that I was losing earlier, and obviously I could have avoided losing, but I did not. I rushed into decisions that weren't right at the time, and I could have seen them, but I didn't. However, it is what it is, and we'll try to get a better time another time. Thank you. Coming to the final boss, Lysandra with 99 HP. And the fact that we have a power that showed its usefulness by discarding the whole hand of our AI, our enemy, our opponent, allowing me to actually go through and win faster than I should have been able to have they had cards to interact with my attacks and so on. Enjoy. As we have beaten Lysandra, I am both happy and sad about my time. The time that could have been sub 15 minutes, but making mistakes here and there cost me time over and over again. But hopefully in the future videos we will get to break our best personal record and even do more records with different champions, and each champion will have different category because each champion have different capabilities. And I still believe that Diana is one of the fastest champion to do this with. Until next video, if you have any idea of a card, deck, concept, or even a game that you want me to try out, if you want to suggest my next speed run, let me know either in the comment section below or in Discord. Remember, I will always reply. Other than that, thank you to fellow gamers for watching. I hope to see you next time. Bye bye.